Hello students, this video we are going to see about sustainability and also about Panchayati Raj. Okay, coming to sustainability, what do you mean by the word sustainability? See, you take supposing your father is into business. How does he sustain that business? What does he do? He would go and he would cater to the needs of the present. How to build it up? How to improve? How to save the resources and get the maximum benefit? Okay, so that will be about the present. Not only that, he will not compromise how you are going to, what is the ability of you children to come up in the next generation. Okay, so he will not compromise on that. So how do you meet your needs? That also comes as part of sustainability. So that's how he sustains the business. Same thing happens here. Sustainability of nature, sustainability of the environment. How do we go about it? Is the definition goes this way: the development of the needs of the present. It's very important, of the needs of the present. How do we develop this? How do we conserve this? How do we improve on this? Not compromising on the ability of the future generations to meet their needs. It's very important. So there are two phases for this. Okay, one is the present and the other one is about the future generations. All right, now going to the sustainability. It has some five characters or principles that we are going to see shortly. The first one is substitution. Okay, whenever something is running out, what do? We substitute it with another thing. Okay, now here what's happening is all our resources are just running out. We have come to a place or a position where our natural resources are in great demand and we don't have the supply, enough supply. So we need to substitute. We have to keep ourselves, you know, on foot and say that yes, we can substitute these things. We need not have these things. Okay, for example, let us take cloth bags and the polythene bags. There was a time when we could not do without polythene bags, and each and every nook and corner, every outlet was providing us with varieties of polythene bags. But today, when we have come to an awareness, the dangers and the havoc caused by polythene, what are we trying to do now? We are trying to substitute that with cloth bags or paper bags. So that's substitution. Then you have renewability. Yeah, there are many sources that are renewable. Now we can take old papers, newspapers, convert it into beautiful bags. That's renewable. Okay, so all waste, we can convert wealth from waste. That is renewability. Then adaptability. See, supposing you had two cars or three cars, there was a time when each one wanted luxury, okay, and comfort. Now let us come out of it and get adapted. For example, we can go into carpooling. We may be having, each one may be having cars, but that doesn't mean that all of us should use one car for one person, but we can have carpooling. So we can adapt ourselves according to the need. So thereby you are saving the fuel. Okay, all right. Then we go to institutional commitment. It's not only an individual, it's a teamwork. Okay, it needs a lot of all government and private and individuals coming up together. That makes a society. That commitment must be there with each and everyone. Okay, and then we have interdependence. This is the transboundary cooperation that also is needed for sustainability. That's what this picture shows. See here, you are tapping in all the renewable resources. Then you have planting of trees so that you don't cut down trees, but instead you're planting trees. And then you have saving water. You're saving the water. So whatever waste water, if anything is going waste, you can immediately switch it off. Or if you can reduce the wastage of water, you can do that. And then this is recycling, renewability. And then together as a team, that is what is sustainability. That we can achieve sustainability. Now we move on to Panchayati Raj. Again here, this is a very, very important thing that helps us to sustain. Okay, because this was started by Gandhiji, who is the father of our nation. And even till date, this 24th April is celebrated or remembered as the National Panchayati Raj Day. This is a brainchild of Gandhiji. Okay, so that's why we have got this here. And he was actually the key thing for about this is, key factor about this is decentralized governance. Actually, what happens is, he says the heartbeat of the country is starting from a village, okay? And from the village, all the strength and support should come from the village. And from the village, it goes to the states. So this will be about the states. And from the states, the country is strengthened. So this is about this Panchayati Raj. This comes from Gram Swaraj. And it's only developing self-reliant village community. There was a time when they were exploited. Their sources were exploited. So he brought in that awareness that the villagers have to stand up on their own. They should be the pillars of the country. And this was made up of basically three units. And that was three levels. What was the three levels? Starting from the village. Okay, so we start from the village, then go to blocks. So many villages will make up a block and many blocks will make up a district. So, and then there are three sources of funds. For anything and everything to happen, we need funds. Okay, and what are those funds? Local grants. See, if any problem comes in a local area, what do? In a layout, we just pull up some money and then get the things done. Same thing happens here. Local grants are there. And the next one is from the center. For example, if you want a hospital to be started or you want a school to be started, it could be a grant from the center or it could be released from the state government. So these are the three sources of funds that we have for the functioning of the Panchayati Raj. Not only that, let us see the functions of the Panchayati Raj. What are they doing? What is the actual function? We see there, the main thing is, because there is about so many farmers they hear and are most of the people are dependent on agriculture. So there are so many schemes that are implemented for agricultural development. So they would give loans for fertilizers, they would give loans for pesticides, they would give loans for seeds, okay, and even for the tractors and everything. So that is about, comes under the schemes. Next one is PHCs, primary health centers. See, there are many places, many villages. Some villagers have to be walking 10 to 15 kilometers to reach a nearby hospital. So by the time they reach the hospital, the patient would be very sick. So here comes this primary health center. In every nook and corner, if the villages have this primary health center, then the medical care is given there. Okay, so they are getting the medical care that is needed in their own villages. Then you have primary schools. You definitely can't expect small kids to walk 10 kilometers to reach a school. Definitely they wouldn't do it. Imagine on a rainy day, or imagine when it is very cold, they wouldn't feel like getting up and going to school. But if it is going to be in their very own village, then they would have the stimulus to go to the school. They'll be motivated. So that's about the primary schools. Then this Panchayati Raj also caters to the drinking water. If you don't have drinking water, it's going to lead to a lot of diseases. So proper drinking water, drainage. Drainage is equally important as drinking water. And then there are roads that need to be set up. Time and again, roads have to be repaired, have to be set right so that it's able, people are able to commute from one place to another. So the connectivity improves. And then you have to develop cottage industries. Gandhiji's vision was to develop cottage industries. That was always there in him. And he started All India Spinners Association and All India Village Industries, where spinning was always encouraged and people used to have this weaving and spinning coming up so that the cottage industries flourished, and then it was marketed. Okay. And then establishment of youth organizations. He believed that today's youth will be tomorrow's citizens and also responsible citizens. So these are the functions of Panchayati Raj, and these are the different characters of sustainability. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you had enjoyed, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye-bye.